I figure one of you guys is Taiwanese. That would be.
Well, it's actually technically two Taiwanese people. I'm one. Okay. I got my citizenship late. And TC also.
Oh, TC.
Yeah. He's written a great book. Really, has written a great book about it.
The Chinese name is Taiwan Mantou Maple Bing.
You guys are doing other things, during the day as well, or when you're not doing music. I mean, what are some of your?
I teach English by trade, and I really like helping folks in Taiwan have a voice in this international language of English. So
yeah.
I teach here to help folks be able to tell the world about what's going on here.
Okay.
Because I like this place.
Okay. Zach and Christina, you guys joined later. What brought you guys to Taiwan?
Well, we came here to teach English.
Okay.
Ended up, both teaching young children, but also music. So we teach English and music.
All right. And David?
I've done it all. I was an English teacher, I was a translator, I've worked as a journalist, and now I'm mostly full-time. I have other music projects, so I mostly work.
All right, so Connor is the only one from the UK.
Yeah.
And you're here because teaching English.
Well, because I'm from the UK.
From Americans, right?
Yeah, right.
Yeah, pronunciation problem.
We got to do something about that accent of yours.
Well, yeah, it hasn't worked out very well, obviously. So that didn't work. So I changed plans, and I used to be a teacher also, and then I went into office work and editing, and I'm still an editor now. So that's my full-time thing. Yeah, and this is I just do this for fun after work.
Tim, I don't think people in Taiwan have seen a lot of washboard playing before. No. You show us your instrument a bit? I mean, and you got a bunch of stuff on there.
Just basically to accent the moves I'm doing, and I scrape it, all right? And I wear on my fingertips some thimbles that I picked up down at Yongle Shichang at the sewing shops. And these I use to drag along the washboard.
Oh, wait, show us. So these are from the
thimbles, that seamstresses would use when they're
that would push the needle through.
Yeah. And so I just put those on the fingertips.
You made that yourself?
Well, this is from the Columbus Washboard Company of Logan, Ohio.
Oh.
And it's a musical washboard.
Oh, okay. So it's broadcast quality.
Yeah.
It's not just any washboard, right?
And I play it for a couple years on one side, and I turn it over and play the other side for a couple more years. Because it wears out. You can't wash too much clothing before you got to get a new board. That's my part-time job is actually cleaning up the laundry for the guys as well.
And speaking of, you guys, I think in particular, you guys go for a more of a flashback look. You guys find?
I think it's when we first did one of our shows, we thought if we wore hats, it would make us look more bluesy or something. And then so we started wearing hats just to kind of make up for our lack of skill. But now we're a little bit better. What's interesting is
we've upgraded our hats.
After we started wearing hats, all the other little blues bands and stuff, they all jazz bands, everybody started wearing hats.
You get the cool cat look.
Yeah, we try.
Well, it's the old style. It's just in the early 20s and 30s, everybody wore hats, no matter what, for all occasions. And people of all classes, that's my understanding.
Yeah,
everybody,
so it does bring a little bit of a, immediately, that retro feel.
Yeah, and it also hides my lack of hair. So.
Dude, Jim, you need a hat. And the instruments, I'm very curious. And your guitar in Taiwan, I would imagine not.
Yeah.
Very, people are not very familiar.
A lot of people love it because it's shiny.
Yeah.
It's very shiny, and it's made of metal. It's called a resonator guitar.
Okay.
And it's basically.
Well, do something.
Yeah, sure. It's basically, sounds metallic. It was a precursor to the electric guitar. Because the design is basically like a speaker cone.
Yeah.
It's like a metal speaker cone. And so it's, if you compare it to a regular, it's an acoustic guitar. If you compare it to like a wooden acoustic guitar, it's maybe four or five times louder. And it's just because of the strings are pressing on this metal pan. And that's how you get that kind of metallic sound.
Yeah, so, we don't see that as much.
So a lot of the early old-time music used these too. Everywhere, from the hillbilly musicians, blues musicians, the early jazz orchestras. If you think about the early 20s and 30s, the pop music of the time was Hawaiian music, right? Mm-hmm. And a lot of the Hawaiians.
Yeah, they had.
There were jazz musicians. It was like a sort of a combination of jazz and traditional Hawaiian music, and they used this guitar a lot.
How have you guys incorporated, you know, your Taiwan flavor gradually into your thing there?
I would say it was pretty natural. Yeah. I think it's when we started doing our own albums, when we started recording our own work, our own songs. Basically, wrote our own songs. And I think you just simply, you write what you know about, and you draw from your what's around you as influences. So we use some, in addition to our traditional jug band instruments, you'll notice we have, sometimes we play a suona. We've got a suona on here. We've also, sometimes we do adaptations of traditional Taiwanese jazz songs.
Okay.
We did a cover, like, there's a Taiwanese composer named Deng Yuxian. Okay. You know, Wang Chunfeng, it's the most famous.
Yeah.
Deng Yuxian is, he's the most famous Taiwanese pop composer from that early era.
Mm-hmm.
And so we've done covers of his songs. We've done our own arrangements of his music for one or two songs.
Okay.
Yeah.
So gradually from working with local musicians and local variety
sure.
of local instruments, and then
sure.
You start working into some of the culture. So, I mean, everybody is here, I would think, is considered in Taiwan, you guys are all foreigners. Except one, I have here one of you guys is Taiwanese, that would be?
Well, there's actually technically two Taiwanese people.
Okay.
Two people with Taiwanese citizenship. I'm one.
Okay.
I got my citizenship late. And TC also.
Oh, TC?
Yeah.
How do you even get a Taiwan citizenship?
I had to renounce my US citizenship and served 2 years in the Army. And
you joined the Army?
I was drafted.
You were drafted?
I didn't do it voluntarily.
And you did how long?
2 years.
2 years.
Yeah,
so that was real stuff back
yeah.
then. It's not the summer camp that the kids are experiencing now.
So. Well, that may change. We'll see.
Yeah. So you did two. How long ago was that?
That was mid '90s, like '96.
Wow. And you became a full-on citizen.
Yeah.
Ever since. What made you decide to do that?
I feel more affinity with Taiwan than I do the United States.
Wow.
He's written a great book. Really, has written a great book about it. Actually,
oh,
so,
really?
Yeah.
What, you gotta tell us. What's the book called?
The Chinese name is Taiwan Mantou Meiguo Bing, and the English version is called Barbarian at the Gate, from the American suburbs to the Taiwanese army.
Barbarian at the gate.
Barbarian, singular, because it's just me.
Oh, Barbarian at the Gate.
Yeah.
Ah, we gotta check that out. But now, going back a little bit to the music, what elements is needed for a song to be transformed into a jug band song?
You need a jug.
That's it? Well, I mean, are there melodies that work more?
And then kazoo. Let's show them the kazoo.
Kazoo? So. Oh, I haven't seen one of those.
Oh my god, it's a kazoo invasion. They're coming.
Every child should have one.
Oh, no, yeah, no, as a parent, I'm telling you, don't buy your kid one of these. I made that miss. Oh, man, I could not get him to stop. Yeah.